In 1974, American jazz saxophonist Azar Lawrence released Bridge into the New Age, his first of three albums for the Prestige label, and from it, the track Forces of Nature. Misty beginning so far, kind of like crystalline almost. Yeah, I love the cymbal right there, the way it just kind of fades in and just kind of, you know, sprays its mist over that introductory woodwind that we were hearing and then just like comes to a halt. Okay, and we've got an all-star cast on this that I shall be just introducing as we hear them. But so far, we're hearing the drums of Leon Ndigu Chancellor. Yes, the ubiquitous one. Okay, now we've got a 7/8 bass ostinato, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah, from John Hurd. Okay, and we're getting some interplay here between the trombone of Julian Priester, who also put out a great album of his own that year, Love Love on ECM. Yes, very coveted release. And let's see, Arthur Blythe, who lends alto sax to the proceedings, and our star guy, Azar Lawrence, of course. And some rather choppy piano interjections there, or piano lead interjections anyway, from Joe Bonner. I love how this piece basically has pure acoustic jazz arrangements, and yet that bass ostinato provides kind of like a form to it, like a choppy, you know, angular form, kind of more that you tend to hear more in jazz rock of the era. Yeah. And spiky, angular, you know, dun 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 dun. And some very tight, kind of spicy trade-offs between the trombone and saxophone. And what you're hearing now is the flute work of a fellow I covered just recently during the 76 of 76 marathon. Yeah, Hadley Kellerman. The bass ostinato that we were hearing just a bit earlier sounded almost like an electric bass, but this sounds like a stand-up, more definitely so. And the percussion that we're hearing is from the ever-ubiquitous Mattoon. Now, I'm having a little bit of a harder time counting the time signature of this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess it's that. the way it seems to kind of like jump on the third of the second bar, maybe, like. Maybe, I guess it's maybe like kind of like a 7 over a 4, 4. Yeah, it almost has like a feel like a like of a 7 placed within an 8. Yeah. Maybe it's kind of like it's supposed to be like for at least one of the instruments anyway. Perhaps the bass like a bar of 7, then a bar of then like a count of 1, then a bar of 7, like. A really misty vibe placed by the symbol there, and kind of an overall hazy misty vibe, you could say, that conjures up the surreal cover art of the album with all kinds of colorful objects and flora, fauna, and even a skeleton just flying out of what appears to be well, kind of a straight rainbow just coming out of a vortex. Definitely hearing, Julian Priester there. As a matter of fact, I was hearing a clarinet that I don't see credited in here. Yeah, this is like the first I've heard of Julian, I think, being in the. And then we're back to that Asanov again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2. The piano's so low in the mix, but it seems to be kind of adding more of the rhythmic element than any kind of like than providing sound or texture really. And now Matum is going into some kind of like more matted sounds. Obviously, his hands are really busy. Like that trombone is kind of like breaking through something that's kind of like muting it and just getting more and more like aggressive. Breaking through a cobweb, maybe. Bursting through. Now we got some more fluid notes playing. Okay, and I think that we are hearing like the let's see, we've got so many, when you actually bring up a scan of the credits as opposed to just what they list on Discogs, you get a whole lot more, well, on various tracks, but he seems to play quite a few sax as our main guy. At Fantasy Studios in Berkeley, California, May of 1974. I'm assuming pretty much all in a single take. Yeah, getting a lot more, a lot brisker, while holding on to the pattern, but just the urgency is building up here. Yeah, the cymbals are kind of like doubling up now. Composed by Ernest Strouder, who doesn't like appear on the track, but he soul keyboardist who appeared on albums from the time period by Bobby Humphrey. Oh, and a lot of like soul funk and soul of the time period, like Blue Magic, Phyllis Hyman, Frida Payne, the band Free Life. Yeah, he was a member of that band, as a matter of fact, huh? And on this album, he serves as like an arranger. Oh yeah, he serves as an arranger as well. So basically the arrangement capacity on this album. And pretty much he arranged three of the five tracks on Bridge Into the New Age. He would also lend his hand to Azar Lawrence's third album, the more kind of a soul funk oriented People Moving. Yeah. And to think, Azar Lawrence was only 21 when this album came out, and here he is like orchestrating all his talent and everything. Oh wow, listen to that that thing of that saxophone of flutter just going about everything and like brimming and prior to this album he had done at least a two album stint with McCoy Tyner. Yeah, played on Enlightenment and Sama Leuka by the jazz pianist. And would also appear right after this on Tyner's double album, 1975 double album, Atlantis. Oh, and here's an interesting bit. Azar Lawrence was also involved in this kind of avant jazz super band, the 360 Degree Music Experience, which put out this like double album of like almost indescribable like jazz. I think that had some steel drum on it, and largely kind of loosely composed, primarily improvisational, as the term's off, but I guess that term could somewhat be applied well to any music in this area, including what we're hearing now, despite the tightness of what we're hearing. Don't tell me that every single note we're hearing was thought out in advance. Unlike the ostinato, which had a definite kind of melodic shape to it, the bass we've been hearing in like these kind of sequences has been more like doom 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 doom, like octave. Now we're getting more back to the tighter thematic ensemble carré play. I love those like doubling up of cadences and such. Went dun 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 dun. Yeah, very frenetic, very like kind of choppy almost, like indicating that things are about to reach ahead. Come to a head. Well, judging by the title, this could be this music that we're hearing right now could represent colliding forces of nature. Yeah, different forces of nature are just colliding with one another. And you know, flora, fauna, germs, you know, sea, land. It could have to do somewhat with like early Earth, a musical like representation of that anyway. And hear that saxophone get all like wiggly toward the end, those final notes, like, yeah, no telling how long that jam, basically, that jam around a structure kind of lasted beyond the 8:44 mark, but yeah, that amount of time captured on vinyl, presumably in one take, yeah, in 1974 by Anne Ringled, by Azar Lawrence for the album Bridge into the New Age, released in 1974 on Prestige, his first of three titles for that label in the span of 3 years, followed by Summer Solstice and People Moving. Yeah, the first two in this vein, and then the third kind of moving more into jazz funk territory. Yes, an accomplished young man. In an industry that didn't have many just spring chickens just kind of rising up, you know, and getting their own albums out, like, by age 21, and let alone three under their belts by the age of 23. Yeah. For more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Azar Lawrence, see the directory of albums by American jazz funk artists linked in the description below. Yeah, I include him in that directory, I guess, more kind of because of like the direction he went in, stuff like more kind of in the free / spiritual jazz / post-bop vein, that would kind of like maybe necessitate a different as yet unmade directory, but he crossed enough areas and over the course of his first three albums anyway to necessitate inclusion, you know, or to merit inclusion anyway. And just so things can be found in a single place. Like and subscribe and follow me on social media and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the track we just heard, the interplay, the harmonics, the layers, the density, the intensity at times, and as well as the structure. And, the directory of jazz funk albums is currently more than 500 albums strong currently. Yes. And until next time, this is Zarg on the world's most air-traveled Trimax most, signing off.